Fuels. Okay, to not get enough sleep can have negative effects on your physical and spiritual well-being. So writer Denise Lin, author of Sacred Spaces, says that what's in your bedroom could be preventing you from getting the sleep you need.
My bedroom is my sanctuary. It's the place that I can go shut the door and really shut out the world. And it's the place where I can connect with my spirit. My bed was made by my husband, and when I'm in it, not only does it carry the love of my husband, but it also carries a sense of strength and stability for me. I don't have a TV in my bedroom. I don't have a phone. The reason being, it was so easy to pick that phone up and start doing business. And that place that was a sanctuary, all of a sudden wasn't a sanctuary. Even an alarm clock can pull you away from yourself. When you wake up first thing in the morning to that jangling sound, it sets an energy for the day. How much better it is to awake to soft music, for example. As much as possible, it's important to have space underneath the bed. Our subconscious mind is aware that directly beneath our body is a lot of disorganization. Every single thing in your bedroom should be something you love or you use.
Computer, please randomize the money. That's all hidden. Now here are the categories to your question.
From my height, from my stature, I'm like, well, popular, I'm on demand.
Today is your day. power is within you. You gotta be kidding me! I still believe the day's mine. Hi. I'm so sorry. I know I said last week I wasn't gonna be late, but...
I'm late.
So, what is new with me, Dr. Young?
Not a lot of good, I can tell you that much.
It's just been one thing after another, and this feels different. Is this a new chair? Has it been checked for bed bugs? Do you mind if I spray it with my anti-bed bug protection spray? I carry it with me everywhere I go. You never can be too careful, Dr. Young. I thought I had bed bugs once. It was a family of spiders, but still. The psychological warfare, not to mention the financial impact. I was devastated. Woo! That should do it. Do you mind if I eat? I didn't have time this morning. You know, I feel like ever since I was born, I've been fighting against time. You know, I was born late? 3 days. It's like I was destined to be late. I think I'm like slow, you know? Yesterday, it took me 45 minutes to eat eggs. Eggs! I wake up slow. I eat slow. I poop fast. Move out of that bathroom. Of course, after I poop, then I have to shower. Even if I've already showered that morning, and I went number two in the middle of the day, gotta reshower. Mm-mm. No, baby wipes are not an adequate substitute, okay? Of course, all that re-showering delays me. It's like you can say to people, oh, that's the reason I'm late. Especially certain people. Are you Mark? Are you Mark? Are you Mark? Hi, I'm Ruby. How are you? Wow, this restaurant looks amazing. I am so sorry, Mike. I am never late. Catch me on a bad day, Mark. Did you order already? I looked online, and beef carpaccio looks delicious. Although, I have a thing about carpaccio right now. I saw the show, 1,000 Ways to Die. Have you seen that show? Very informative. So there's this one case of a stripper in Las Vegas, and I guess, you know, she's running late to work. Like we all do. And she used a rusty razor in her shower, and from that, she got a flesh-eating bacteria. It ate all her skin off. She died. Hence the title of the show, 1,000 Ways to Die. Anyways, I showed a picture of what her leg looked like, and it looked like beef carpaccio. I read Anthony Bourdain's book. I read a blog about the book. And it said that due to high customer volume, restaurants don't always have time to properly clean the utensils. So I just take it for myself to wipe them down and the table. I'm not OCD. I'm thorough and informed. Wrong again, Mark. I'm not a germaphobe. I'm germaware. You know, studies show that there is more fecal matter on most cell phones than public toilet seats. Not on mine, because I wipe mine down 3 times a day with alcohol wipes, but on yours, on his, definitely on his. fecal matter. Oh, do you have to pee? Well, where are you going? Well, I thought we were having a good time. Is this about the fecal matter? Hey, J-Date. I'll have an order of your carpaccio. I was right. That carpaccio was delicious. Anyways, I'm just gonna focus on my career, you know? Do me for a while. And in 2 years, I'll get my shit together and I'll be good to go. And everyone will be knocking on my door. I haven't done my solo show yet, but I performed an original song I wrote in open mic last week.
Coming up next to the mic is Ruby Perez.
Perez.
Hi, Cafe Lulu. My name is Ruby. I'm not a singer-songwriter, but I am a human being with feelings. This song is about a bad date. When I come home, I gotta wash my hands, scrub as hard as my skin can stand. But not before I take off my shoes. You never know if you stepped in poo. If I don't do that first, I feel panicked, out of sorts and all manic. Stop telling me I'm total OCD. I get my facts from Daylight NBC. But naturally sustainable, organically farmed. Protected plastic sheets. See your lips moving towards me. So let me check your mouth for her beefies. Statistics say that's probably not a fit. That's an open sore. Take care of it. Did you know a sneeze can travel 20 feet? And there's over 90 strains of HPV. It's my neuroses turning you on. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, I left my oven on. I left my oven on. Oh my god. Don't worry, that's just part of the song.
I am your father.
There's a sale of Cheerios this week. Two for one, two for one.
We represent the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild.
Welcome to the Rock.
I wear my crazy eyes now.
But naturally sustainable, organically farmed, biodegradable, American made, non sweatshop produced.
Protect a plastic sheet. Okay, I'm freaked out. Let me explain what it's all about. I know what I am, but I'm normal. But I'm careful, I'm not mortal. Who wouldn't want to take a battery of tech to make sure NFTDs are limited?
Did you know that if you put a mirror on the east corner of your bedroom wall, you invite love? I was up all night reading about feng shui and drawing out how to best arrange the furniture in my apartment to achieve flow. Actually, I have the drawings with me. I can show you. Ooh, exciting. I made 11 floor plans. Whoa. So, if I move the glass shelves in between the windows, then the width of the shelves will make the windows look wider, which gives the illusion of more space. And since the shelves are glass, then the light coming in through the window will reflect off the glass shelves, bouncing light all around the room, giving the illusion of more space. Dr. Young, keep up. The shelf is equal to the height of the... What? I haven't gotten rid of my stuff yet, but I started. I went to Goodwill last weekend. Just put it here. I said some decluttering. Much needed. Piles were getting so big I was walking around like a mouse in a maze trying to get from my bed to the bathroom. Got too embarrassed. I didn't want to have people over. Especially guys. I didn't want them to think I was a crazy cat lady. I don't have cats. But who knows? Maybe I prevent myself from hooking up with the serial killer, huh? Yes, I would like a tax form. Thank you, Jen. My name's Ruby. You know what? Why don't I just look at what I'm giving you, and then I can mark it up on the form.
Cool.
My gray fleece pants. Oh, I wore these all the time in college. I wore them to dance class, to Spanish class. After class, come up on my corner chair. I couldn't afford a real couch, so I bought a wedge of a three-piece sectional for $25. Clever! The crotch is a little bit worn out. But the waistband still stretches. Look at this, Jen. Look. Look at that elastic. Look at it. I could still wear this. I'm just going to take this back. My crazy creek camping chair! Now I know I did not put this in here. Jed, you are looking at the first piece of furniture I ever owned. Yes, that's right, before the corner chair. You are a good listener, Jed. I got this at Ollie's Outlet, Bargain Barn, Discount Dollar Store. It is a real place. Look it up. And I paid $1.99 for this, Jed. Can you believe it? Oh, the times I had in this chair, Jen. Good times, good times. High times, low times, drunk times, high times again. You can easily clean puke or chocolate pudding pop stains off this. It's really comfortable. Doesn't look like it would be. You know, I could still use this. I do sit all the time. What do you think, Jed? Keep it? Donate it. Keep it? You're right, it is my decision. I'm gonna keep it. Okay, I'll leave it to it. Goodbye, things. I hope you go to a good home. Bye, Jed. I would love to leave my dual-deck VHS player with you, Jed. I really would, but there are still some VHS tapes at home that I have to watch. Look who's talking. Look who's talking to. Look who's talking now. I want to know who's talking. It is true. I haven't used it in 7 years. But that's only because I have to get this certain type of cable cord to go with this new TV that I got. And I haven't gotten around to getting to it yet. But I might, Jed. I might. And I don't want to be the kind of person who gives up on her dreams. Because I have a dream that one day I will walk into Radio Shack and inquire about that cable cord. And maybe they don't make that cord anymore because the technology is too old. But that is what eBay is for. Today! Today is the day that I get that darn cable cord. Jen, if you wouldn't mind opening the door for me, oh my God, hello, Radio Shack. You know what? This dress, I just have to get it hemmed, and then it will go on me. There's some shoes in here that I really wanted to get fit on my feet. Yes, these ones. They are still good shoes, Jen. I just have to make my fat feet fit into them, okay? And this I got at a sample sale. It doesn't fit right now, but it will once I lose 10 pounds, and I will lose those 10 pounds, Jen. These are my Care Bear socks. I've had them ever since I was 6. Care Bear stare. No, Ruby, no! They no longer fit your feet. Put it down. But I could use these as dusting rags. You know what, Jen? I'm so sorry, but there is just nothing for me to donate to you today. Fret not, I will return. I think I have like
4 hammers at home. Now we need 3. Still have to return that hammer. I better write that down, or else I'm gonna forget. I can never finish one thing, you know? The thing is, I do believe that given the time, I will be able to get to everything. Because I am not a hoarder, okay? I have a label maker, and I use it. I'm a purposeful saver of items. Not a hoarder. Despite what my friend Annie says. Bueno, Dios mío! Oh my God, Ruby! Santa Maria Jose. This is really bad. Did you do that? Oh. Very cute. Okay. Organizer Annie is here. We're going to make 3 piles, okay, Ruby? We're going to have a trash pile, a donut pile, and a keep pile. And from the looks of this, we're going to have trash to throw out. Just, it's very clean, but it's too much. Let's go over here. What's this, all these post-it notes on your desk? Buy toothpaste. Have you done that? Oh, good. So we can throw it out. So just put it on your phone. There's an app, an add-in app. It tells you every month what you run out of. Okay, fine. We keep it. What's this post-it? Cheerios commercial, too serious, ? Is this a joke? You can't remember. Okay, then let's throw that. But it's not funny. Fine. They're both fucking a show. Have you done that? No? Okay, so it's not important. What's this? A party planning folder? Were you planning on throwing a party here? No, Ruby, no. Mira, a party planning folder is not a thing people have, okay? That's what Eva is for. I use it for my cousin's quinceañera. Okay, fine, we keep it. But we're about to off of 4th right now. Just as a baseball term. What's this? Anthony Robbins, a VHS series, Live Your Best Life. Are you living your best life? How long have you had these? It's not even open. Do you even have a VHS player? No. 2 of them? No. Okay, Ruby. When are you going to watch these? But you haven't. But you won't. But you aren't. No, you haven't, and you won't, and you aren't, and it's okay. Okay, fine, let's set a date. Great. In 8 weeks, I'm going to check in on you and see if you're living your best life. Carajo! Boxes upon boxes. What's even in this? Israeli youth gas mask with NATO filter. Is this for a sketch? In case a second Holocaust happens? Okay, Ruby. Yes, a government coup can happen at any time, but I think this is part of a whole kit. Okay, Ruby, if a second Holocaust happens again, you're going to need a little bit more than Pop Tarts, Oprah magazine, and Alviva's and Butthead sound machine. You're going to need a new identity and a passport. Do not break it down. Ruby, stop it. Mira, you're going crazy like my tia Linda. Mira, she's beautiful, she's smart, she has tetas out of here. But no man wants her, because she's a hoarder. Said it. Hoarder. Yes, you are. Don't you wag your finger in front of my face. Okay, you know what, Ruby? I can't help you if you don't want me to help you. But if you have a flood or a fire, you and yourself will not survive. This is combustible! Fine, I leave. I'm being claustrophobic in here anyway. Oh yeah, don't be late to my birthday brunch. They give away the table if we're not all there. On time.
What a bitch! But I know she's trying to help, but... You know, maybe she's right. Maybe that's what I need, like, some external force of nature to just wipe out all the clutter for me. Because it's bad. You know, I'm still reeling from that Porter's Anonymous meeting that you sent me to last week. There's a group circle. And hand-holding. You know what? We don't have to talk about it. But since when is animal hoarding not animal abuse? Okay? 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 Okay. I'm not one of those people. Okay? I'm just slowly sifting through my stuff. Well, I guess it is interfering with my life. Yes, it's preventing me from having social interactions. I don't think I'm a hoarder because everyone likes me. I'm very social. People think I'm like super fun at parties. What happened this morning? Oh, well, this morning I had a little bit of a train issue, you know? But it's very hard to get to, Dr. Young, because you're on the Upper West Side. Very difficult. I live like 5 subway stops away from you. But I have to get on the train. The train.
Yeah, but you also have people who have garbage and rotting food. That sounds, yeah. I mean, that goes beyond saving magazines because you there's a story in there that you plan to read sometime in the future.
Yeah, I mean, you know, on a daily basis, that person truly believes that they're going to get to it, but they never do. Procrastination is one of the biggest factors that lead to hoarding. You know, no follow through. In this case, when we're talking about reading, you know, the fear is if I let it go, such a life of technology that you can pull up anything nowadays on the internet. You know, the bottom line is we all hold on to stuff that we don't really need, but we can hold on to them for various reasons. And at the end of the day, really what it comes down to is, are you giving up putting things away that do have value that you use because you are holding on to stuff that you don't really use and it's taking up space? And so, yeah, so my theory is
that... Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
I didn't make it. So I wouldn't have been as late. But in truth, I would have been late, Dr. Young. I don't even know why. Something happens when I'm about to leave my apartment, and it's like 15 minutes of my time is just gone. Boom. Ah! What? Chest, and I can never breathe, and I'm never at peace. I'm obsessed with time. It's like I'm Einstein. Except I have a deficit. Attention, deficit. It's a disability. I mean, not like a disability. It's something I battle daily. Oh, did I tell you about my latest battle? No, not that one. No, but the one with the postal service is ongoing. Okay, so check this. My health insurance company, which I pay $420 per month out of pocket, is no longer covering me for my ADD medication. With coverage, it's $20. Without, $945. That's just for half the dosage.
Everybody get down to bed.
Member Ruby Perez. Member ID Y2K. Oh, that's weird. No, not O. Agent! Oh. Y as in yellow, 2 as in toddler, K as in Krispy Kreme. Oh, that'd be good right now. No, not O. Operator, help! Help! Hello? Hello? Janet? Yes, you can't help me. Janet, I don't know how much time we have to talk because the very medicine that I need to deal with this sort of thing is the very medicine that you are no longer giving to me. And I am running on pure liquid rage right now, you guys. My member ID? But I already told it to the computer. Y as in you, Janet. 2 as in tarted. K as in kill me. Oh, you have it. Great. Okay. So I've been taking 15 milligrams of dexedrine twice a day since I was 14. Uh-huh. Okay, so what's the deal? Why are you no longer covering me? A pre-existing condition? My brain is a pre-existing condition? Well then, Janet, by that theory, we're all pre-existing conditions because you can't function without a brain, Janet! No, don't go. Janet. Now, Janet, we don't have much time. In my brain that I need to concentrate that you all have and take for granted I lack. You refusing me this medication, it's like refusing somebody who has seizures their medication. It's a neurological disorder, and I will not stand for this because Ruby Merez yields to no one. That's a title for my memoir. What's the title? I've tried the cheap generic stuff, and it is crap. I'm on it right now. I've had to up my coffee intake 3 times a day and down 7 pixie sticks just to get through. Blue Cross Blue Shield is not covering all mental health medication for New York City. What excellent news. As if we don't have enough insane people here. Okay, so Janet, what do I do? Okay, I need a friend, and I'm calling in for a friend, all right? Because someone wants to be a millionaire. Be my friend. What do? All my medical records? Since I was 14? Okay. Priority mail. Notarize it. Attention to. Member services. Photocopy it. Post office. Cookies for myself. Kinkles. References call. Case number on every page. Fax it. Microfiche. Okay. We're gonna have to start over. You know, I haven't done any of that, Dr. Young. I still have to get like a box to put all information in, and then I can start. I was at a container store yesterday, and I like spaced out for 83 minutes. Do not suggest meditation again, okay? I just said I'm taking a nap. It's a waste of my time. But anything else, any other advice, I'm open to. So lay it on me, big guy, because I'm tired of talking.
Frequently not being focused is a symptom of feeling overwhelmed. I think your situation, the issue is that you have so many interests, but your follow-through isn't as developed. The good news is that you're not alone. This is common for those with ADD. The trick is finding strategies that can keep your mind from drifting. Anchoring your attention is an important skill to develop. So, as your attention drifts, the likelihood that you'll miss important information increases. Therefore, the next time you feel yourself losing focus, why don't you try these tips? First step is awareness.
I think I left my tampon overnight. Okay, I remember changing after rehearsal last night because I went in and washed my hands before I went to the bathroom, and Laura asked me if I only came to the bathroom and washed my hands, and I said, no, I always wash my hands before I go to the bathroom, and she said that was weird, and then I realized that she wasn't someone who did that, and then I changed my tampon. But then, did I take it out later? Oh, God, I don't remember at all. I do feel a little warm. And dizzy. If reading is hungry, hungry. What's the signs of taxa shock syndrome? Is it nausea? Cramping? Wait, am I confusing PMS with toxic shock? Do they have the same symptoms? Come on, Ruby, think. God, am I dying right now? I'm gonna return that tank top to Express. What if I keep exploring the color orange? It never looks good to me. Oh God, I never sent out my mom's birthday gift. post office. I just have to get a stamp. Why can't I make that happen? It's too hard. You feel mad, Diana. God, why could I remember? Oh God, Dr. Ann, stop talking. Quick, we're sorry.
What? Sorry. What? What?
Has your mind simply wandered midway through the page onto something else? Is that something that happens to you?
Page? Oh, the book that you loaned me. Getting things done. Yes. Thanks, but no thanks, Dr. Young. This book is so not for people who have ADD. There was no pictures, no bullet points. I couldn't even get past the back cover. And who is this guy anyway?
David Allen.
Look at him, all smug like he has no problems. He probably suffers from halitosis and erectile dysfunction. I'm sorry, that was mean. I just, thank you, but no thank you. So, do you have any other books you can recommend for me to help me get focused? Get organized now. Oh, that's the name of the book. Hold on. Let me write it down. Organize now. All right. I will pick it up when we're done. Oh, we're done. That was 45 minutes? Right, because I was 19 minutes late. All right. Well, another week. Nothing accomplished. Oh, by the way, I wanted to ask you something. I'm taking this memoir writing class, and I'm having trouble thinking of the title for it, and I was just wondering if I could bounce off a couple names with you. Bounce off? You know what? I'm going to add that to the list. Oh, that's another good title. Add that to the list. All these titles I'm coming up with. Okay, here are the other ones. Getting sidetracked. You snooze, you win. It's not crap, it's my stuff. Annie, get your gun and get out, colon. Unless that was my prop gun, in which case, leave it and then get out, colon. Because Ruby Moran's yields to no one, colon. And memoir. Too insidery, right? We'll find it, Dr. Young, we'll find it. Hey, I don't want to toot my own horn, but last week, I was 29 minutes late. This week, 19 minutes late. So, baby steps, Dr. Young. Baby steps. Oh, baby, that's the title of my memoir!
Thank you.
And he likes me. For me. Can you believe it? You can? Aw, Jim. No, I don't want this to sound like a case of I met a man and then I got my shit together. No, 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 no. I started before him. And then he came into my life. Yeah. I guess I made space for him. I had a yoga ball and he said he was fine sitting on it, but I thought it was better to get us a love seat. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, I don't need this stuff anymore because David, oh, that's his name. He's my constant. My constant? You haven't seen Lost, have you? Okay. If you watch any episode of Lost, watch The Constant. Penny is Dez's constant, what keeps him grounded, what keeps him. Keeps him centered in reality when he's on another string of time, space continuum. You have to see it.
Penny, is that you?
Dez, what are you?
I'm on a boat. Penny, you still care about me?
Of course, Dez, I've been looking for you for 3 years.
I love you, Penny. I've always loved you.
I love
love you, Des. I don't know where I am, but I'll find you. I'll come back to you. I know you will. Don't give up on me. I won't give up. I love you. I love you. I always have. I always will. I love you. I love you. Anyways, I should be going. We have dinner at 7, and it is... Oh, it is 4. I gotta get going. Right, Pasha, you will be seeing me weekly, probably for the next 3 years. For change is not overnight, but yet a constant and steadfast journey. For the blossoms of love cannot bloom in a field of junk. For love needs room to grow. A memoir. Mm-hmm. Bye, Jed. Hey, next week, I'm gonna bring you that hammer I've been telling you so much about. Anything else coming back takes me a pie?
Yeah.
No. I did take something on the way over here, though. Oh, you keep me honest, Jed. I want you to have it. It's a bow tie from when I catered once. You got fired for eating the food. They have a lot of rules. Anyways, I want you to have it. Maybe you could wear it here, huh? Ooh, you could dress up as a caterer for Halloween. Oh, or was Frank Sinatra? He wore a lot of bow ties, especially after 15. You get a drinking problem with a bow tie. Thank you so much for coming. Yeah.